Whoa there, Olly. Careful.
I can't help it, Stan. I'm too excited about tomorrow.
So is Ben. This is the first time we've entered the Bumpton Dog Show.
Do you think we can win the cup, Stan?
Of course. Just so long as we train hard today. Practice makes perfect. Stay and sit.
Come on, Ben, you can do it.
He's done it.
Is Ben okay, Stan?
I think he hurt his paw when he landed. Let's get you home for some rest, Ben, and we'll see how you are in the morning. Bad news, Olly. We won't be taking part in the dog show today. Ben's paw's just too sore.
Oh, dear. Poor Ben.
Yeah, but you'll be back on your feet in no time, won't you, Ben?
Oh, it's a shame we can't go to the dog show, Stan. Especially after all that training we did.
I know, but Ben needs to rest. And I can't take part in a dog show without a dog, can I?
That's true. Stan, what if I said I knew a way that Ben could rest his paw and still take part in the show?
How could he do that?
You'll see.
Farmer Dan and his sheepdog, Scrumptious. And last but not least, please welcome Stan. And in a late change to your program, Stan will be taking part with Olly the Little White Bam.
Are you sure this is a good idea, Olly?
Of course. We're a great team. What could go wrong? Besides, we'll have help from a friend. Oh, there's no need to thank me, Ben. We're best friends. I'd do anything for you and Stan.
Ladies and gentlemen, Stan, Olly, oh, and Ben.
You are my best friends and I'd do anything for you. Follow you anywhere. You want me to go and do exactly what you want me to do. You are my best friends, of that I'm very sure. I'll do anything for you forevermore.
Sit! Now dance!
You are my best friends and I'd do anything for you. Follow you anywhere. You want me to go and do exactly what you want me to do. You are my best friends, now and forevermore. I'll jump through any hoops, but now I'm stuck for sure.
Never mind, Ben. We might not have won the dog show cup, but having best friends like you and Olly is all the reward I need.
Stan, what do I do now?
The only thing you can do. Stay! Oh, I'm only kidding, Olly. Let's get you down.
Bye, boys. Have fun.
See you later.
Hi, Stan! What have you been up to?
Hi, Olly, Jethro. I've just been on an emergency call. There was a dog up a drain pipe, so we rescued it, and that's it. Phew, it's very exciting. Where are you going?
Jethro's taking me birdwatching.
Oi, down Bluebell Woods we're going. Go watch some birds and that.
Why don't you come along?
Oh, yes. That sounds very relaxing. It's exactly what I need. Lead on, Jethro.
Oh, What's that?
Oh, what's that?
That'd be me, Olly. You want to see a bird? We've got to sound like a bird. Nice and peaceful like.
I see one! I see one! Look! On the fence over there!
Careful, Royston. You're scaring the birds away. Oh, no. They've all gone.
Well, not all of them, Olly. The one I spotted is still there. Look, oh, I think it's a chaffinch or a budgie or maybe...
an old rag hanging off the fence.
Well, don't worry. We'll just wait here until the birds come back.
Well, not while they can see old Royston here. All bright red and that.
Oh, Jethro's right, Olly. I'm too loud and too colourful. I don't blend in enough to go bird watching.
You make a good scarecrow, though.
Hang on. Royston, stay there. I've got an idea.
Easy, Olly. What are you up to now?
Hey, that's not very nice, Olly.
Don't worry, Jethro. Oh, I think I know what Ollie's doing.
Hey, you're blending now, Royston.
Thanks, Olly. Now I
really blend in with the woods. So let's spot some birds. Sparrows have blue tits, it's birds that we spot.
Cuckoos and magpies, we see such a lot.
Chaffinch and robins all up in the trees.
A dog on your back, beware you don't sneeze.
Some thrush and blackbirds are making a nest.
Woodpecker, skylark, but spotting is the best.
Whoa, that was fun! Thanks for helping me blend in, Olly.
You're welcome, Royston. I've had a fantastic day. But look, how are we going to get clean? We're completely covered.
Don't worry, Olly. I've got a few good friends who can help us.
Okay, boys, let's get them clean.
Olly the little white man helps his friends as much as he can. Olly the little white man always around to give a helping hand.
Come on, Olly. I'd like to get back in time for lunch. I'm starving.
Righto, Stan.
Olly, look out!
Whoa!
Whoa!
Are you okay, Olly?
Yes, thanks, Mandy. What happened?
I'm sorry. I threw a ball of string and it hit you. It was meant to lure down that cat stuck in the tree.
That's Crockett. Oh, he belongs to Meg, the antique shop owner. She'll be worried sick.
But how do we get him down?
No problem. I'll go and get help. Stan, you can stay here and try to coax him down. Back soon!
Right, come on, Mandy. Here, kitty, 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 kitty. Meow! Maybe we better just wait for Olly. Don't you worry, Meg. Royston will have little Crockett safely down in no time.
Oh, I do hope so.
Oh, that's it. Come on down now. Good little kitty.
You've done it, Royston. Well done!
Ah, yay, me! Royston, the red fire engine, helps his friend as much as he can.
Oh, Crockett!
Sorry, I got a bit excited.
It's okay, Meg. I'll catch him, I promise. Crockett, I'm not trying to hurt you. Slow down, please. Oh, I'll never be able to do this. I can't climb and jump like a cat.
Ah, but Olly, to catch a cat, you've only got to think like a cat. Yes?
Yeah.
I'm a cat, and a cat likes chasing mice. No cats here. A goodbye, mice. Meow. I'm a cat, and a cat likes milk. No cats here either. I'm a cat, and a cat likes sleeping.
Olly, have you got my precious little Crockett?
No, Meg, I haven't got Crockett. But since cats love sleeping, I have a good idea where he might be.
Oh,
where?
There.
Oh, he came home.
Yay!
Shush.
Yay!
Thanks for finding my darling little Crockett, Olly.
It was nothing. I just had to think like a cat. Meow.
Olly the little white man helps his friends as much as he can. Olly the little white man always around to give a helping hand.
Oh, this is brilliant!
Oh, careful, Olly. It's pretty tricky driving in snow, you know. You've got to take it easy.
I'm too excited to take it easy, Stan. It's Christmas Eve.
Hey, what's going on over there?
Use a low gear. No, use a high gear. No, not that high. Go slower. No, go faster.
Oh, Tom, this is useless. It's just too steep.
Hi, you guys!
Are you gents having a spot of bother?
Hey, you could say that. We've got a delivery of animal feed for Bumpton Zoo, but it's at the top of this hill. And with all this snow, it's just too slippy to get up there.
If we don't get this feed up to Zookeeper Willy, the animals will have nothing to eat over Christmas. Well, that's him now.
Hi, Tom. I've got two very hungry lions here, and all I've got to feed them is a bunch of bananas.
Hey, you! Come back with those!
I think they're pretty desperate up there.
Hey, why don't you load me up with the food, and I'll have a go. I love the snow!
All loaded, Olly.
Well, let's go!
Go on, Olly.
To get up that hill, you need more speed.
Well, that's no good, it's grip I need.
If you need more grip, we'll add more weight.
Oh, you'll never get up there at this rate.
There's trouble here at Bumpton Zoo. There's a hungry bat and a kangaroo. With a 6'8" who's in a mood, because it's Christmas Eve and we've got no food.
Why don't we push? We're all quite strong.
This is no use, it'll take too long.
How about driving tilted on one side?
I can't keep my balance with this load inside.
There's trouble up there at Bumpton Zoo. There's a hungry bat and a kangaroo. There's a 6'8" who's in a mood, because it's Christmas Eve and they've got no food.
Yeah, Dan, are you sure this is the only way?
Aye, rockets, boys. 'Tis the only way.
Okay, let's give it a go. Start me up, Stan. Whoa!
I've got an idea. Are you lot busy?
Oh, he's been gone quite a long time, Stan.
Hey, listen to that.
No, it can't be.
It is. It's Olly!
Come on, Stan, hop in. We've got work to do.
Ho, ho, ho!
Merry Christmas!
Oh, are we glad to see you.
Stand down, chaps. There's plenty of bananas for everyone.
Olly the Little White Van helps his friends as much as he can. Olly the Little White Van, always around to give a helping hand.
There you go, Alfie. Some yummy food for you. And your bed needs making too. Oh, helping out at the zoo is so much fun. Ah, Alfie, you're a funny fellow with your big floppy ears and your pointy tusks. And that trunk, whoa, I wish I had a snaky, shaky trunk like you.
Here, Olly, why are you talking to the elephant? He can't understand you, you know. Blah, blah, blah. Hey, Bazza, what have I told you about pulling faces at my animals? Now, come on, Olly, let's go and feed the monkeys. I'll teach you to laugh at me, Olly. Yeah, I've got an idea. Here he comes. I'm going into town to get some shampoo for the lions. You're in charge while I'm away, okay?
Oh, yeah? Oh, this is so exciting. I have to look after the whole zoo! Zookeeper Olly, at your service, Alfie.
Hello, Zookeeper Olly.
Who said that?
I did. Alfie the elephant.
No way! You can understand me. And you can talk. Oh, if only Bazza were here to see this.
I'm sure he wouldn't believe his ears.
Oh, this is so much fun.
Now, what was that you were saying about being at my service?
Yes, Zookeeper Olly always wants to help.
How about you help me by giving my home a fresh lick of paint? These walls look so dreary and grey, you know.
Yeah, good idea. Ta-da!
Oh, that's so much better. Bright orange, the best colour in Bumpton.
Is there anything else you need me to do, Alfie?
Ooh, now that you mention it, a makeover for the zebras. A new playground for all the animals. A rubber ducky for old Sharky. And a typewriter for Marlow. Now, there's just one last thing I need you to help me with. A surprise birthday party for the lion.
Olly, what have you been doing? This isn't how you look after a zoo. Oh, Olly, I'll leave you in charge and look what happens.
But it was Alfie. He told me to do it, didn't you, Alfie?
Pff, a likely story. If animals can talk, I'll eat my hat. Oh, that I'd really like to see.
Hello, Willy. I'd really like to see you eat your hat now.
What?
See? I told you he could talk. Hang on. What's this? Bazza!
The monkeys told me to do it. Well, that explains it. It was Bazza all along. Olly, I should never have doubted you. But as for you, Bazza, you need to clear up all this mess you've made and you can start by bathing the zebras. Me? No way. I'm not... No! 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 All right, I'll do it. I'm sorry.
Seems Alfie's actually... actions speak louder than words, eh, Bazza?